and simple. It's 1, 2, 3. Technicality beats everything. There's nothing fancy about it, man.
Yeah, yeah.
Hey, Tony perfects.
Okay, let me ask you and Audley Harrison. Audley, Klitschko against Joshua. Who do you think I put my money on?
Ladies and gentlemen, gather around the boxing ring. Gather around the boxing ring. We got something a little special for you.
I got Joshua.
We got something a little special coming up.
So, this is very important now, okay? So, Joshua, obviously, is the new guy on the block coming up. Hasn't really put a foot wrong. But I think with Klitschko's experience, you've got to put him the favorite, okay? If Klitschko holds him with the jab, leans on him, ties him up, all that stuff that Klitschko does, he's going to make it difficult for Joshua. But at the end of the day, if Klitschko unravels like Klitschko used to unravel, but we haven't seen that for a long time. When he fought Samuel Peter the second time, you kind of see that he now knows how to handle a big, strong guy, moves away, ties you up. So, but Joshua, kind of don't know what he's like at that level when he goes, you know. We're not quite sure, but he's done everything right so far.
He's like yourself, a gold medalist?
Yeah, yeah, but as a pro, he's done everything right, but he hasn't really been thrown in the deep end yet. This is the first step up where he's fighting somebody established, and Klitschko's like learned how to win doing it his way. Hasn't been the most exciting, but he's been doing it effectively. Other than when he fought Tyson Fury, he's been able to close everyone out. So I think Joshua's definitely got a chance to upset the uppercut, but my thing is if Vladimir comes back, especially Vladimir, like with something to prove, because he lost to, you know, he kind of threw it away, didn't he? When he threw, it wasn't Vladimir that we kind of see.
Against Tyson Fury, yeah, terrible.
And I don't want to make excuses for him because I know his wife had postpartum depression.
You know your shit. I'm impressed.
I'm a student. You can't talk to me. But I do know that if Klitschko does what he's supposed to do, which is line, timing, and distance, Joshua's gonna have a hard time closing him out, and then if he does close him out, like Lennox used to do, you just sit on him and bring him down. And Vladimir's learned that, but Joshua's gonna be in it, and you're gonna have, just like when Frank Bruno fought Tim Witherspoon, out on his feet, you know, 10 rounds, that's the kind of fight it's gonna be. And so Joshua's either gonna have to run out of steam or make a big mistake for Vladimir to capitalize on. You get what I'm saying? So that's how.
That was an epic explanation. Agree?
That's how the clone
fight. I see where it's coming from.
You saw, I interviewed Jeff Mayweather this week and he told me very similar things.
Yeah.
I think the only thing with Joshua, talent wise, he's got it. Skill level, he's got it. But like you said, at that level, we don't know what he has.
Yeah.
Experience wise, you know, it's two different fights. You know what I mean? Like, it's just two different fighters, two different levels. And
this is going to be his first fight where he has to understand the fundamentals. And he hasn't really had to do that. You know, that's why Lennox lost early on, until he got the teachers to give him the fundamentals. Joshua hasn't really learned the fundamentals of a pro, and that's no disrespect against his trainers. He's learned how to knock people out, be in great shape, fitness. But the top of the
it's boxing, different levels.
Yeah, yeah.
People don't realize, like, when you beat everybody at a certain level, when you get to that top-notch level, everybody has great attributes. Yeah. Speed, power, everything.
But
it's the intangibles.
Tony Jeffries, like, he has Joshua easy.
Easy. I think Joshua's going to knock him out. I think he is. I think it's going to be
could happen as well. That's not great. That could happen.
Vladimir's going to make it hard though. Vladimir.
Yeah.
I'm not going to say he's a dirty fighter. But when you're an experienced pro, you know how to clinch. You know how to fall on.
He didn't have to do that before. Now he knows how to do that.
You know how to do that. And a lot of fighters, when they haven't experienced that, and all they have is actually.
I think it comes down to footwork. I think it's footwork.
Yeah,
Joshua's footwork's great.
But he's got to judge distance.
Okay. His footwork's got to be great.
He's got to be able to judge distance well.
Yeah. Timing and distance is the key.
Tony Bellew, David Hay.
So obviously Bellew and Hay. No, I'm gonna keep it up. And I love Bellew to death, love David Hay to death.
He's a great dude.
Right? Both of them. Right? But the thing about it is, again, I think David Hay has been in this situation many times in his career. Okay, Bellew hasn't been in this situation as many times. He's been in a few and he's moving up. Everything's against Bellew. But you know, Bellew's the heart of a warrior, heart of a lion.
Right now.
Champion. It's like Bellew, all love for Bellew, love Bellew to death. But I think David Hay has got his bit between his teeth for this fight, just like when he fought Derek Chisora. And I think if David Hay makes too much of a mistake and goes in there and they just back and forth, you don't know what it could be. But I think David's going to come in there and just stay one step ahead of Tony. I think that's what's going to happen. But Tony Bellew, you cannot write him out.
Okay.
So I'm this fight is like, I think 60-40 in Hay's favor. So that makes it a real compelling fight to watch.
You guys are three of the nicest people, coolest people in boxing. What would you do if Derek Chisora threw a table at you?
Shit. No. I mean, come on. We know what Derek Chisora is like. So it's like, that's kind of, I'm kind of putting that on Eddie Hearn. Really, like, he knows the game. Okay, you've got, you, they just had a kickoff the day before in the Sky Sports thing. Then you've got them sitting on the same dais. Well, you know, they're supposed, that's supposed to be shut down. You have to have a security like Lennox Lewis and Mike Tyson. Come on, Eddie, you know the game. You could have prevented that. That's him. You can't blame
Rashad said he would throw the table back at him.
Yeah, but, you, but the thing about it is...
I don't even have words for what I'm doing.
Yeah, yeah, but the thing about it is the promoter's got to protect that because you're going to do that as a fighter.
But it does sell. Do it does sell that.
It sells, but the problem is he's now 20,000 pocket. That's 20,000 pounds. That ain't no chump change. 20,000 ain't no chump change.
You're right.
And that could have been avoided by having security.